The leader of the FDC Katonga faction, Erias Lukwago, has condemned the intrigue happening among members of the opposition in parliament. Speaking to the members of the press yesterday at the Katonga offices, Lukwago said that infight and intrigue among members of the parliament in the opposition only weakens the opposition bench.
The ruckus going on within the opposition forces in parliament is the most disturbing thing right now. We are really disturbed because those are our frontline troops at parliament. We need to put our house in order to confront the challenges of the day.
Lukwago also spoke out on the proposed amendment bill being fronted by Richard Lumu, the Mityana South Member of Parliament. In the bill, Mr. Lumu wants the law changed to warrant the election of both the leader of opposition and the chief opposition whip. Lukwago is calling for a unified voice by opposition parties to block the proposed amendment.
There have been attempts at amending the law regarding, I don't want to call it erecting, but there has been attempts before at amending the law regarding the constitution of the opposition leadership in the House.
Lukwago also informed the public that they have assembled a team of defense lawyers for the 32 FDC Katonga members who are battling charges of terrorism in court.
Our colleagues have not been accorded the right to speedy trial. And the state has even invariably attempted to deny them trial in open court, which is a variation of the law.
Hundreds of supporters, friends and relatives gathered in celebration on Saturday in Pondo to welcome Ms. Agnesius Wamakuyu Mutimi, the Member of Parliament for Elgon County in Bulambuli District, following his release on bail after spending 6 to 8 days in Luzira prison on allegation of corruption. Accompanied by the beats of Kadodi and chanting his praises, supporters expressed joy over the release of the legislator. The Bulambuli District LC5 chairperson, Annette Nandudu, expressed her joy over the release of Mutimi, who she labels an asset to the community of Bulambuli.
Bulambuli is happy like nothing. Yeah. We have been longing for this gentleman in Bulambuli. Mutimi is a resource to the people of Bulambuli.
We pray that the court exonerates him and he continues to serve Bulambuli as the area member of parliament until eternity.
Mutimi, who preferred not to talk about the matters before the court, was happy to have attained his deserved human right of freedom, at least for now. The legislator is battling charges of diverting public resources and conspiring to defraud the government between 2019 and 2023. He was granted bail alongside his co-accused by Justice Jane Okwo-Gajuga of the Anti-Corruption Court in Kampala. The Israeli military said that it had found the bodies of 6 hostages in a tunnel in the southern Gaza Strip, including a U.S. Israeli and a Russian Israeli. Their remains were recovered on Saturday from an underground tunnel in the Rafah area and returned to Israel, where they were formally identified, the military has said. It is said that the dead hostages were Kamel Gat Eden Yerushalmi, Hash Goldbach, Pauline Alexander Lebanov, Almok Sarusi, and Ori Danino, who were all seized by Palestinian militants during Hamas' October 7th attack on southern Israel that triggered the ongoing war. Gat was taken from the southern Israeli kibbutz community of Beri, while the remaining 5, ages 23 to 32, were abducted from a music festival near the Gaza border. They were among 251 people taken hostage during the October 7th attack, 97 of whom remain captive in Gaza, including 33 the Israeli army says are dead. Israeli Defense Minister Yoav Gallant said the 6 hostages whose remains had been retrieved were alive when taken captive. Months-long talks for a ceasefire and to secure the release of hostages have so far failed to have a positive outcome, with both Israel and Hamas blaming each other for the delays.